Hey everyone, I thought I would try something new today and do a vlog. I just went on my first interview for residency. For those of you who don't know, I'm applying to internal medicine this year. So I've applied all over the place. And so I've been getting these interview invites and I have to travel all over the states. I'm really excited about it. The last interview I had was in the South in Tennessee. And I really enjoyed myself. I was very stressed out before that interview because it was my first interview and I wasn't sure, how it would go, how everything was going to be, but it was pretty good. I had a good time. So the way that most interviews work is that they will have an interview day. And right before that day, the night before, they will have a dinner. But for this particular interview, we had a dinner that night. So on the interview day, we got to experience how their academic half day is. And after that, we had our interviews with the faculty. And at night, we had our interview dinner with the residents, which was really nice because you get to talk to people who are actually in the position that you're going to be in the next year, and you get to ask them questions like how they like it there, what are the benefits of going into that program, and why did they choose that program. So it was a really nice way to get a look at the program that wasn't just what the faculty was going to end up showing you. What was really nice about the program where I went was most of the interview was actually them asking me if I had any questions, which of course when you go for an interview you're going to have a lot of questions that you want answered that are maybe not given on Frida. And so when you go for an interview, make sure you do your research. Always go through Frida, go through the list. See what is on there that you like. You might probably have done this before you apply because it helps you narrow down your applications as well. So since you're applying to the program, you probably know why you're applying. And so just remember those things and remember that when you go to the interview, you're going to have to answer the question, why are you applying there? Why do you want to go there? That was the most commonly asked question. After, of course, just do you have any questions for me? As far as the dress code goes, for the interview dinner, it was kind of like a relaxed business casual. You don't have to go super dressy to these things, but it is business casual. Don't go in jeans, usually, unless it's specifically stated. Sometimes they might take you to, a more relaxed place, a bar, something like that, if it's just the residents. So definitely pay attention to the dress code. And the interview day dress code is, of course, a suit. And for girls, it's a skirt and a jacket, or you can wear pants and a jacket. I wore pants and a jacket. I'll put in a photo of what I wore a little later, but basically it's my profile picture. So I wore a lighter colored suit, but when I got to the interview, most people were wearing pretty, like the standard black and blue suits. So maybe it's not a good idea to stand out. I'm really not sure at this point. But I do have to buy a second suit anyway because I have so many interviews coming up. So that might be something I do. I might buy a more standard suit. So when you book interviews, make sure you're really, really nice in your emails to the program. The program coordinator is a really important person. And just in general, a good rule in life is to be nice. Being rude and mean or frustrated with anyone in life is really not going to get you anywhere, right? I mean, that's like true all around the world. So I guess there are people who get a little frustrated, especially if you have to change your interview dates or something, but don't. It's not going to help you. So just, stay calm and be nice. So I got in a day before my interview because coming from the West Coast, going, farther east, there is a time difference. So I wanted to get used to that before I went for the interview. So keep that in mind when you go, especially if you're traveling a lot. That there are going to be time differences, especially if there's going to be an early morning, like 7 a.m. interview. You should get there a little early so that, if you can. I know if you have interviews back to back, it's going to be difficult, but try to get that time difference settled. Most importantly, have a lot of fun because this is your time where you get to evaluate the program yourself. When you go for an interview, always remember it's not just them who are interviewing you, you're interviewing the program as well. So you have to be a good fit for the program. So always keep that in mind. That will keep your nerves down and you'll have a little bit more fun, which you're supposed to do. Try to really get to know the residents for the one night. I know it's a little weird to suddenly hang out with people for one night, but it's nice. It's a relaxed atmosphere and it really helps you to get to know the people there. After the interview day, make sure you come back and write about it. Write it down. How did you feel? What was your gut feeling about the program? What are the benefits, the pros and cons basically of going there? For those of you who have been following me on Instagram, you know that I've been using the first aid book, First Aid for the Match. And at the back of that book, they actually have a form. I'll show you on Instagram. I'll put a picture up. They have a form that's really, really helpful to, and I turned it into an Excel sheet. So if anyone wants to use that, I can actually post that. I will. I'll post that below this video. And the Excel sheet is basically going to help me evaluate each program according to what I'm looking for. You can obviously modify it to help you, and that's about it. I hope that was helpful, and it's just a sneak peek into what I'm doing right now. It's the reason I'm not going to put up regular videos for a while. I might vlog like this once in a while. I'll probably try to do it right after an interview just to tell you guys how it went. So please let me know if you guys have any more suggestions for my vlogs or for my regular videos. As always, you can email me at studentdoctorsunite@gmail.com. Or you can comment below this video and I will get back to you as soon as possible. Thank you guys for listening and for subscribing and liking my videos. I really appreciate it.